for some insane reason, it took insanely long to get this to actually show up properly. But we got it, and we're here. So, let's get started. Demo got an update on the 21st, so a few days ago. I'm really on track, aren't I? With a new Juan section. Let's do it normal. Yeah, hope everybody's doing good.
Hey,
it's time to check out some more of these guys.
Just them?
Guess so.
Oh, there's Bird.
Oh my god.
He ain't coming back.
Bird's got him.
That city they're headed to, is that?
Junar. Shinra territory.
I thought it was Juwan.
Come on.
Not Junar. Oh well. Uh-huh. Chocobo friends. Fountain Company's travels have taken them all the way to Junon's doorstep, explored the region around this heavily guarded metropolis, while facing off against vicious fiends. Alright, map. Team composition. Okay. Everybody's here. Let's take a look at the team. So right now I am Cloud, Red, 13, and Aerith. Party. How do I change the party? Yeah, I actually want this party. I want Cloud, Aerith, and Tifa. That's what I want. If I set Tifa as leader, does that mean that I control Tifa? No. It just means that I'll control her if I go into battle. Okay. I thought I was a leader then. I love seeing red 13 on the menu with Chocobo. Oh god. Alright, well, can we go in here? Cannot. It's like we really have no choice but to do this.
Where did that bird even come from, you think?
There's a story about a great condor said to roost on an island's abandoned reactor, though there's no longer any way to reach the isle, or at least none that I'm aware of.
They just finally reclaiming what Shinra stole.
Well, even if we could get there, I'd rather not bother. Didn't seem very friendly.
Agreed. Let's focus on where we can go.
Hello! I want my camera to be back just a little bit, though. Yeah, HD chocobos.
Thank you.
Got those tail feathers. What we got here? Oh, that's right, you can follow. How do I dismount? You can follow the little baby chocobo. Oh my god. Yep, that's a Final Fantasy creature. Bintar bus stop. I guess it's how you open up fast travel spots. Also, he's got a nut on his butt. Oh yeah. But these guys, it seems like it's a hold R to just like sort of go over things. Nut butt baby chocobo. Make that an infinite craft. Yeah, let's just explore a little bit. I really have no idea what our objective is. Fiend sighting 4.
Alert! Dangerous fiend detected in your vicinity. Please ensure you are prepared before engaging. My sensors are picking up some understandable confusion.
Who are you?
It's a pleasure to meet you, Cloud. I am your personal monster assessment instrument. But since that's a mouthful, you can call me Mike. Chadley programmed me to assist you by providing detailed analysis of the fiend to encounter. Yeah. I hope I can be of service to you in the many battles ahead. With that out of the way, I'm picking up unusual fiend activity nearby. To procure the biological data that we require, you'll need to complete specific objectives during combat. But don't worry, because I'll be here to help you succeed. Good luck.
I smell fiends.
Level 21.
Commencing guidance protocol. A strange amalgamation of species. The Chimera's addition to the animal kingdom coincides with the advent of Mako. This timing is likely no coincidence, as Mako energy's adverse effects on creatures is well documented. Fossils.
Alright, well, let's see if we can take them out.
Ancestor to the rotting Chimera. Scientists postulated that the fiend actually has particular origins. Providence aside, the fiend is a proven threat to any living near its ever-expanding territory.
Pressing one of the four action buttons while guarding the vicinity. Okay, synergy skills, that's right.
Ready? Oh, yeah.
Please take care while squaring off against this mysterious bug. Currently gathering combat data on target. Oh no! What do I do?
Oh shit, I only have like 2 minutes to beat these things?
Here it comes.
Yeah, that's not happening.
Let's go!
I'm in! Now turn this around!
Don't worry, I can handle this.
No, I don't think you can.
Go on!
I'm surprised that you're waiting for the demo to get started. It's a weird thing to say. It's like normally you wouldn't think that more of a demo would actually end up existing. Yeah, this isn't gonna happen. Yeah, it's not surprising.
You'll be blown away.
probably over. I'm sorry.
I thought I was stronger than this.
I'm sure you are, but not right now. Can I just escape the battle? Okay, good. I don't have to, like...
I smoke fiends.
Chimera berry.
I don't actually have to go after them. Okay. Imagine PS1 demo discs where all the demos... where all the demos requiring you wait for more demo content. Yeah, I mean... in this day and age of internet connectivity, the idea of having additional info added to your demo is not an unheard of idea. They got a little chunkabo kick. Awesome. I mean, heck, I even heard that they were adjusting something in the main game based on comments that they've received from the demo already. So. Demos are a big deal. Especially if the companies like take them seriously at least. Huh, I should be able to get up here, right? That just sounds more like a free-to-play game than anything. Alright, well, I guess that's a no. I'll see if I can run past those people. Watch me be stuck down here forever. They make pleasing sounds, these chocobos.
Better not let your guard down.
Chimera variant identified.
That would explain why they wouldn't let me go up there. Well, I mean, you give me the ability to go places. I'm obviously going to try. Run away. They would release different demos, though. There was always the opportunity to have demos that gave you access to different areas. That's not an unheard of thing. Pressing one of the four ashes. Okay.
Coming.
Just that. Nice.
quicker.
It all just kind of depended on the company. Yeah, exactly. Like, you would get different demo discs with your different magazines throughout the year, right? And then sometimes it'd just be trailers, but then other times you would get full playable things. I also liked it. Oh god, I would buy like the Xbox demo. I would buy the Xbox magazines specifically because they had DLC for like some game, or maybe they had. Sometimes I think they even had like Rock Band stuff, which I'm a big fan of, so I had to have all that. So I used to collect those. I still have a couple that have like specific DLCs on them. Where are you going, young nutbutt? Classic chocobo. I'm sensing some sort of crafting. I put in a code for Pro Skater 2, basically unlocks everything minus the secret character, so I can access the later levels, yeah. That's another thing, there were always like codes that like would unlock. They say they would unlock everything, but it wasn't everything. You have to, like, use a different code. Who wanted to be Spider-Man? Where's my chocobo? Oh, okay. There we go. I'll stick around a little bit more, but then I'll head towards the goal. Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Bring all the monsters.
Well, look at that! Another chocobo ranch! I wonder where the owner's hiding.
It helps that Never to Stop made a Spider-Man game. Yeah. It actually does make sense. It makes sense as to like why they would have access to that character model. What's this? A lot of materia, jeez. I'll leave that stuff alone for right now. God, getting into like RPGs and stuff is so daunting sometimes.
Business is booming at our one-stop fashion shop.
Fashion shop. Okay. Let's see. Shinra Avian Helmet. Shinra Breastplate. Yeah, why not?
Give that bird a pat on the head for me, will ya?
I wonder what gear they're wearing right now. How do I change the gear? how they chose Wolverine to be in Pro Skater 3? I guess so, maybe.
Junon's Chocobo Ranch. Perhaps you were already aware, but the chocobos here are raised on a diet of feed, seaweed, and fishbone meal. Unsurprising, given the local industry.
Okay, we'll leave Chadley alone.
I wish
alone.
You all the best in your ongoing hunt for world intel.
For right now. How do I equip new gear to my chocobo? Ah. I understand. I don't know, you'd be surprised what people can get away with when they have specific access to licenses. They get all sorts of Easter eggs here and there, especially back in the day. It seemed it was a lot more common back then, too. Ed Shrek and Darth Maul. I mean, it was either money or it was like marketing, you know what I mean? Somebody was like, I'm a fan of your stuff, and my kid's gonna play this stuff. So how about I put this property that my kid's gonna like inside your game?
You're up.
Let me at him. Gotcha. That's the way to do it.
Firstly, I find the idea of like Shrek being in the game even like wilder than like Spider-Man or Wolverine. It appears this is a thing that I can do. Or not yet. I also feel that Star Wars properties were a lot easier to share back in the day. Like, I almost feel that unless it's a Star Wars thing, you're not going to get that cross promotion like you do these days, or like you did back then.
Let's go.
I'm here.
Ready?
Okay.
Just like that, okay?
Let's not dig too deep into this demo. I want to, like, fully play all this stuff when the game comes out, so let's just sort of move ourselves along, shall we? EA didn't have full grip on the license for Star Wars.
I don't like the look of this.
Personally, I wish that more companies would do the cross-promotion. I think that would go a long way to show, like, goodwill and fair sharing for everyone. I mean, yeah, I get that there's, like, licensing rights and money and legal things, which sucks, but I wish it was just more common. Use a cushion to rest. Okay, so there's a cost to rest in the overworld at these things. Which makes sense, because with the older game, you would have to use... tents and stuff, right? Excuse me. Remember the Crash Spyro marketing scene where they advertise each other's series? Yeah. They were big on it.
Sinners always gotta have someone stuck on. It's their friggin' MO.
I mean, it makes sense to me. I feel like Nintendo could do that a lot more. They got so many cool franchises to play with. They could put more Easter eggs and shit in. Ready to become obsessive compulsive with pushing the triangle button everywhere that I go.
One moment. Welcome to Under Junon, our sunless oasis. My name is Rhonda. I'm the mayor and sheriff around these parts.
Sup, Rhonda.
Turn you in and be $100,000 richer for it.
Well, you know what they say, can't take it with you.
Hmm. And Aerith to boot, huh? That's another half a million on top.
Half a million?
Down here, though, we know when to turn a blind eye. Consider our lips sealed.
Sorry, but I call bullshit.
Well, I don't think you would if you knew even half of what my town's been through. You don't like it? Leave. But over there, there's a quiet little inn where everyone's welcome.
I think she was just more impressed that she had a higher bounty than everyone else. Like, combined.
Behave yourselves now.
I didn't specifically see Cloud on that list, though. I can't tell where that's coming from.
We gotta go! Now! There's a monster attacking the boat!
It's too much.
This better not be a joke.
This way! Oh, down here!
Have you seen the gate lately?
Quickly! Please!
This is terrible. What do we do?
Yes, I understand that there's a seat there.
This way! Down here!
Hey! Look out!
Quickly!
Okay.
Please!
We gotta get the quirky teenage ninja to join our crew. Doesn't look good. She has to have something to help her counteract the suffering from the Nazi or Aerith syndrome, so.
Get its attention.
On it.
I saw this platform and I'm like, I'm gonna have to fight something here.
Get him!
I'm doing great.
I got it.
I'm gonna fail this. I'm gonna fail it so hard.
This fight's not over yet.
Not it.
I had this. I know I did.
Oh god, yeah, return. Was I even like properly healed in the first place? That's the big question that I have. I am. Okay, good.
Let's go.
With you.
Do it.
Ready.
I don't like. My friend. You may have no choice.
People. Don't overdo it.
Going well. Painfully died. Show's release date. Yeah, pretty much. Yep, crap indeed. We're gonna lose again. I feel like I need a different party.
You'll be out before you know.
Okay. Everything he says just makes you laugh. Oh god. I'm not paying attention, or I'm just not prepared. So let's prepare better.
She gonna be okay?
Wait, aren't I able? Okay, we'll go with this. Then we'll have Baron. Yes, I am aware. Cast the Protect on Cloud would probably be a good idea.
Let's go!
Now, 50 times.
Come on!
suffice.
I need curing. Jesus Christ.
I got this. Time to get serious.
Just sit tight. We got you.
The game is nice enough, but doesn't have Goofy talking about Heartless.
Keep your eyes on the water. God live in the world.
You're right. It certainly does. Catastrophe, yes. That giant fish is the dark bird of Sephiroth's heart. Careful, Cloud, that dolphin might get horny. Oh, that's it. Yeah. Oh, stylish clothes for the crew. They're gonna want me to do a whole bunch of stuff in this game, aren't they?
Gotcha.
Honestly, I feel like I'll be better when I play it from the beginning, too. Because I will attempt to read the explanations of things better.
And there it was.
Because that's like my big problem when it comes to RPGs. Like
you coming?
Alright, well, I guess I need to play something else. You mean this game is on PS5? Yeah. All right, well. What game do I have in currently? I think it's that, but honestly, I kind of just feel like playing Mario Party right now. I'll play these games tomorrow. Let's play Mario Party. Take a quick break.